I am Ra. I greet you in the love and in the light of the one infinite creator. We communicate now. Question 34.1. Questioner, the instrument would like to know if two short exercise periods per day would be better for her than one long one. Answer, I am Ra. This is incorrect. The proper configuration of the physical complex exercising during the three-month period wherein the instrument is vulnerable to physical complex distortion intensification needs the strengthening of the physical complex. This may appropriately be seen to be one major period of the exercising followed late in your diurnal cycle before the evening meditation by an exercise period approximately one half the length of the first. This will be seen to be wearing upon the instrument. However, it will have the effect of strengthening the physical complex and lessening the vulnerability which might be taken advantage of. Question 34.2. Questioner, you stated at an earlier time that penetration of the eighth level or intelligent infinity allows a mind, body, spirit complex to be harvested if it wishes at any time space during the cycle. When this penetration of the eighth level occurs, what does the entity who penetrates it experience? Answer, I am Ra. The experience of each entity is unique in its perception of intelligent infinity. Perceptions range from a limitless joy to a strong dedication to service to others while in the incarnated state. The entity which reaches intelligent infinity most often will perceive this experience as one of unspeakable profundity. However, it is not usual for the entity to immediately desire the cessation of the incarnation. Rather, the desire to communicate or use this experience to aid others is extremely strong. Question 34.3. Questioner, is it possible for you to tell me what I experienced around 1964, I believe it was, when in meditation I became aware of what I considered a different density and different planet, and seemed to experience moving on to that planet? Is it possible for you to tell me what experience that was? Answer, I am Ra. We see some harm in full disclosure due to infringement. We content ourselves with suggesting that this entity, which is not readily able to subject itself to the process of hypnotic regression instigated by others, nevertheless, has had its opportunities for understanding of its beingness. Question 34.4. Questioner, thank you. Would you define karma? Answer, I am Ra. Our understanding of karma is that which may be called inertia. Those actions which are put into motion will continue using the ways of balancing until such time as the controlling or higher principle which you may liken unto your breaking or stopping is invoked. This stoppage of the inertia of action may be called forgiveness. These two concepts are inseparable. Question 34.5. Questioner, if an entity develops what is called karma in an incarnation, is there then programming that sometimes occurs so that he will experience catalysts that will enable him to get to a point of forgiveness thereby alleviating the karma? Answer, I am Ra. This is, in general, correct. However, both self and any involved other self may, at any time through the process of understanding, acceptance, and forgiveness, ameliorate these patterns. This is true at any point in an incarnative pattern. Thus one who has set in motion an action may forgive itself and never again make that error. This also breaks or stops what you call karma. Question 34.6. Questioner, thank you. Can you give me examples of catalytic action from the last session beginning with the self and manifested producing learning catalyst? Answer, I am Ra. We observed your interest in the catalyst of pain. This experience is most common among your entities. The pain may be of the physical complex. More often it is of the mental and emotional complex. In some few cases the pain is spiritual in complex nature. This creates a potential for learning. The lessons to be learned vary. Almost always these lessons include patience, tolerance, and the ability for the light touch. Very often the catalyst for emotional pain, whether it be the death of the physical complex of one other self which is loved or other seeming loss, will simply result in the opposite, in a bitterness and impatience, a souring. This is catalyst which has gone awry. In these cases then there will be additional catalyst provided to offer the unmanifested self further opportunities for discovering the self as all-sufficient creator containing all that there is and full of joy. Question 34.7. Questioner, Do what we call contagious diseases play any part in this process with respect to the unmanifested self? Answer, I am Ra. These so-called contagious diseases are those entities of second density which offer an opportunity for this type of catalyst. If this catalyst is unneeded, then these second density creatures, as you would call them, do not have an effect. In each of these generalizations, you may please note that there are anomalies so that we cannot speak to every circumstance but only to the general run or way of things as you experience them. Question 34.8. Questioner, what part do what we call birth defects play in this process? Answer, I am Ra. This is a portion of the programming of the mind, body, spirit complex totality manifested in the mind, body, spirit of third density. These defects are planned as limitations which are part of the experience intended by the entity's totality complex. This includes genetic predispositions, as you may call them. Question 34.9. Questioner, thank you. Can you give me the same type of information about the self in relation to the societal self? Answer, I am Ra. The unmanifested self may find its lessons those which develop any of the energy influx centers of the mind, body, spirit complex. The societal and self interactions most often concentrate upon the second and third energy centers. Thus those most active in attempting to remake or alter the society are those working from feelings of being correct personally or of having answers which will put power in a more correct configuration. This may be seen to be of a full travel from negative to positive in orientation. Either will activate these energy ray centers. There are some few whose desires to aid society are of a green ray nature or above. These entities, however, are few due to the understanding, may we say, of fourth ray that universal love freely given is more to be desired than principalities or even the rearrangement of peoples or political structures. Question 34.10. Questioner, if an entity were to be strongly biased toward positive societal effects, what would this do to his yellow ray in the aura as opposed to an entity who wanted to create an empire of society and govern it with an iron fist? Answer, I am Ra. Let us take two such positively oriented active souls no longer in your physical time-space. The one known as Albert went into a strange and, to it, a barbaric society in order that it might heal. This entity was able to mobilize great amounts of energy and what you call money. This entity spent much green ray energy both as a healer and as a lover of your instrument known as the organ. This entity's yellow ray was bright and crystallized by the efforts needed to procure the funds to promulgate its efforts. However, the green and blue rays were of a toweringly brilliant nature as well. The higher levels, as you may call them, being activated, the lower, as you may call them, energy points remaining in a balance, being quite bright. The other example is the entity, Martin. This entity dealt in a great degree with rather negative orange ray and yellow ray vibratory patterns. However, this entity was able to keep open the green ray energy and due to the severity of its testing, if anything, this entity may be seen to have polarized more towards the positive due to its fidelity to service to others in the face of great catalyst.